Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what is enthalpy of a particular reaction or a standard enthalpy of a reaction, and now what we are going to do is we are going to study about what is standard enthalpy of formation and what is standard enthalpy of combustion. So let us talk about it. So now we are going to study about the two topics, that is standard enthalpy of formation and standard enthalpy of combustion. So let us start with the first one, that is standard enthalpy of formation. So what is it? Let us understand the definition of it. So it says that it is defined as the enthalpy change accompanied in a reaction in which one mole of a pure compound in its standard state is formed from its elements which are also in the standard states. So what does this mean? It is very much simple to understand. It means that we have to form a particular compound or a particular molecule from its constituent elements or atoms from which it has been formed. And the energy required or the change in energy that we observe during the formation of this compound is known as enthalpy of formation. So for that, we have a small example for this so that you could understand in a better way. So first of all, let me tell you that it has been denoted by delta H naught. This H naught stands for standard. And here, as you could see, a subscript, that is F, this stands for formation. So therefore, this is nothing but the standard enthalpy of formation. And now, this is the example where you could see that H2 plus half of O2, that gives us H2O. And in this case, the physical states are also been mentioned for the reactant as well as for the products. And in this case, what it has been found that the change in enthalpy, and we could clearly precisely say that the standard change in enthalpy for the reaction is found to be minus 286 kilojoule. So this standard enthalpy of the reaction or the heat of the reaction that they have mentioned here is minus 286 kilojoule. But how can we predict that what would be the enthalpy of formation? In this case, the enthalpy, the standard enthalpy of formation will also be, that is minus 286 kilojoule. As you could see that in this case, basically H2 has been formed. So specifically the enthalpy of formation, the standard enthalpy of formation for H2O is minus 286 kilojoule. So this is how, where the H2O has been formed. So since H2O has been formed from its constituent elements like H2 and oxygen, so that's the reason the energy required or the change in energy that we have observed during this transformation from H2 and O2 to H2O, that kind of change in enthalpy that we have observed makes the standard enthalpy of formation for H2O, and hence the standard enthalpy of formation of H2O in this case is minus 286 kilojoule, which is nothing but equal to that of what we have did in the standard heat of reaction or the standard enthalpy of a reaction. So it is almost the same. But when we are talking about the heat of reaction, and in the last lecture we have studied that the heat of reaction is nothing but the difference between the enthalpies of the reactant and the enthalpies of the product minus the enthalpies of the reactant. So in that case we didn't observe that there was change in enthalpy. We always used to discuss that there was always the difference between the enthalpies of the product minus the enthalpy of the reactant. So because of this thing, that is what we have calculated or what we have got to know, that the enthalpy of formation of the water as well as the heat of the reaction of this reaction particularly is almost the same. The both are same. So therefore, this makes a very good application for us to understand what would be the standard enthalpy of a particular reaction. So what are the application of it? Let me tell you that also. So first of all, let me tell you what would be the application of delta H naught F. Since we know that the enthalpy of a particular reactant and product can be calculated, or but we are also knowing that the change in enthalpy is much more easy to calculate than that of the one which has a particular enthalpy that we have studied in the lecture when we did for enthalpy. And now, what is the application of the standard heat of formation for this reaction? It would be very much simple, because usually we got to know that the enthalpy, that is the enthalpy of the reaction, that is the standard enthalpy of the reaction, was product minus the reactant, that is enthalpy of product minus enthalpy of the reactant. But because of the standard enthalpy of formation, we could also predict what would be the heat of reaction or what would be the standard enthalpy of the reaction. It can be written as, it will be the summation of the standard enthalpy of formation of products minus summation of standard enthalpy formation of reactants. So it is very much easy to calculate. So let me give you a small example. This example we have did earlier too, but now we are going to do again, but of different terms. And what are those different terms, we'll see in this lecture. Suppose if we have a reaction, like suppose A moles of A, which is reacting with B moles of B, that is giving me C moles of C plus D moles of D. And in this case, suppose we have to calculate what would be the standard enthalpy of the reaction. So it would be very much easy to calculate if we do, that is H naught, standard delta H naught, which is nothing but the enthalpy of the reaction. It will be summation of the enthalpy, the change in enthalpies of the product, or the formation of the product, the heat of formation of the product minus the heat of formation of the reactant. So in this case, where we could see that C and D, the both are being said to be the product, so I could write it as C moles or C times that of delta H naught F of C plus D moles of delta H naught F for D, the whole minus with the reactants that we have did here. So we could write delta H naught F for A plus B, that is number of moles of B, into delta H naught F for B. So this is how we could calculate what is the standard enthalpy of the reaction with the help of the standard formation of the reaction, or enthalpy of formation of a particular reactant or for a particular product. So this would be very much easy to calculate what would be the heat of reaction. So this was the thing that we have did for a standard enthalpy of formation. So now let us do with the another one that we have. And we have standard enthalpy of combustion. So before understanding what is standard enthalpy of combustion, we should also know that what is actually combustion. Combustion is nothing but the reaction in which oxygen has been involved, as well as where oxygen has been involved, and oxygen plays a very vital role in burning a particular substance. So therefore, combustion is nothing but a reaction of oxygen with a substance, so as to get oxidized for that substance, also has to burn that substance in presence of oxygen. That is known as combustion. So let us understand it in a better way by knowing what is the definition of it. So basically, it is defined as the standard enthalpy change that accompanies or that is being calculated from a reaction in which one mole of the substance in the standard states react completely with oxygen, or when it is completely burned. And I said earlier that is to burn or to make a substance to undergo combustion, oxygen is the main content that we need. So in this case, what happens is we are reacting the oxygen with one mole of a substance, and during that substance, the substance will get oxidized or undergo oxidation, or we could say that the substance will get burned. So during this process, what is the amount of enthalpy change that we could observe? On that basis, on the combustion basis, that kind of enthalpy is known as standard enthalpy of combustion. And for that, it is being denoted as. So now, since delta H of C is basically denoted for the enthalpy of combustion, And because it has been denoted here also, as you could see, that it has been denoted by delta H naught of C. And this H naught refers to, yes, it refers to standard states. So it can be called as standard enthalpy of combustion. So combustion is basically the reaction in which a substance is undergoing a reaction with the oxygen so as to get undergo oxidation. So similarly, I have given a small example here so that you could understand it in a very easy way, where you could see that C2H2, basically ethene, when it is reacting with the oxygen molecule, and it forms two moles of carbon dioxide plus one mole of H2. So in this process, what happens is the heat of the reaction that has been calculated, or the enthalpy of the reaction that has been calculated, it has been found to be minus 1300 kilojoule. So this says that the enthalpy of the reaction in this process, minus 1300 kilojoule of energy is being evolved from this system or from this process. And when we are talking specifically, when we are talking about what would be the enthalpy of combustion for the substance. So in this case, the substance is, because this is the oxygen, and the substance which is undergoing oxidation, or the substance which is burning or on which the combustion happens, is in this case is C2H2. So therefore, we could write it as the enthalpy of, standard enthalpy of combustion of C2H2 in this case is the similar one that we have got here right now, that is minus 1300 kilojoule. So this is the amount of energy that is being required, or that is being released when C2H2, that is ethane is undergoing oxidation process, or when it is undergoing a combustion process. So this is the amount of energy that is being released. So it is very much simple to understand that what is the enthalpy of formation. Formation is nothing but the how much change that we observe when a reaction is taking place and when a substance has been formed. While in case of combustion, when a particular substance is being reacted with oxygen, so at that time, what kind of enthalpy change is observed during that combustion process, that is known as enthalpy of combustion. So because this was a reaction that you have got to know, and it is very much simple to understand. So that's it. Thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you will try to do this kind of subject more and more. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.